achieved a lot, but I missed out because I lacked on efforts. Because I lacked on efforts, there were times that I failed. In fact, in my school, I failed for 1 year. In my college, I failed for 2 years. Because of this 3 years of failures in school and college, I graduated. Because I graduated late, I got a job late. Because I got the job late, I got a promotion late. I even got married late. The only thing which happened on time or before in my life is my birth. I'm a premature birth. And I found a way of compensating that early introduction to nature with all the delays that I just mentioned from my academic years. I'm glad that some of you are laughing, rather most of you are laughing, because so did I. But when I failed for 2 years in the first year of my graduation, all of a sudden it wasn't fun anymore. Because my classmates would graduate in a year's time. And it was almost like a snakes and ladder game. My classmates would graduate, possibly have a job, climb up the ladder. I, on the other hand, was gobbled down by the snake, taken back to start from the scratch all over again. I was sad. There were dark clouds of shame looming over me. There was a thunder roaring and asking me, Samuel, how can you be so casual about your studies? There was a lightning of bleak future ready to strike at me any moment. I was sad, I was depressed, I went into depression. I even had to see a psychiatrist. But all is well. The snake couldn't keep me gobbled down for long because of my family. Because all throughout my failures, my family believed in me with their eyes shut. My brother, my sister, my father, my mother, all of them, they believed I'm brilliant and not an idiot. And I can tell you this very assuredly, that when your loved ones believe in you more than you believe in yourself, it almost works like a miracle. I did graduate. I in fact even did post-graduation. I went on to work for some reputed organizations and continue to do so. But failure has a way of catching up with you, doesn't it? It did. What failure does very beautifully is that it instills fear. And what fear does very beautifully is that it defines your comfort zone. And I went into comfort zone of enjoying my hobby, which is watching cricket and over-analyzing. Going into the comfort zone of being in the same sales job with MSD Pharmaceuticals for many years. Until my wife encouraged me to apply for a promotion. And my wife being my wife, I had to listen to her. And when I applied for promotion, I asked help from many people, my colleagues, seniors, competitors, and every door that I knocked for help opened it and embraced me with a smile. I eventually did get promoted, but it was not merely because of my capacity. It was because of all the people, and especially my wife, who believed more in me that I can get promoted than I believed in myself. And then a very strange thing happened. The human resources department, the HR department, called me up and said, Samuel, congratulations, you're promoted, but... It's like, okay, you gave me the question, what's the surprise? You have to move out of Mumbai. I was like, no way I can move out of Mumbai. Do I have any option? I asked her. And she said, no, you don't have any options. So I said, it's only one way. And she said, yes, it's only one way. And there, I land up in the city of one ways, Bangalore. And I told you about fear and failure that define your comfort zone. They also have a sister concern, which is doubts and suspicion. And what they do very beautifully is that they shrink your comfort zone. And that is what happened to me when I came to Bangalore. I was suspicious and scared of everything around me. When I came to Bangalore, I was scared of the way the movie posters over here look. The traffic. I don't even know why we have fourth and fifth gear in the car, yeah. The junction, it doesn't look anything like a circle, but they call it a circle. There's a bar close to my house. I thought people are going to get drunk and come and rob my house in the night. I was scared, you know, of silly things. But, and I made up my mind, you know, that no matter what, I'm going to find some way out and go back to Bombay in 6 months. 6 months. But it's been 4 years. 4 years in Bangalore. And I love each inch of Bangalore and every moment that I spend here. And it's not because that my wife and I are adaptable, but it's because of some very Some people who believe that a migrant can, like me, can make a fortune for himself than the migrant himself. And those people were the beautiful people of Bangalore. And in the end, I would just like to take you back to where I started. I endorse what my father said. I know that I can be brilliant at public speaking, but only if I practice only. And that brings me here to Toastmasters. And if fellow Toastmasters like you believe in me more than I believe in myself, I'm sure I'll make it through. Mr. Toastmaster.